you again. Five unmistakable marks by which you may know wheresoever you go, the warranted genuine snarks. Let us take them in order. The first is the taste, meager and hollow but crisp, like a coat that's a little too tight in the waist, with the flavor of will-o'-the-wisp. We have sailed many weeks, we have sailed many days, 7 days to the week, I allow. But a true snark on who be my lovingly gaze, we have never beheld till now. His habit of getting up late, you'll agree, carries too far when I stay. That it frequently breakfasts a 5 o'clock tea, dies on the following day. The third is his slowness in taking a gesture. You happen to venture on one, it will sound like a thing that is deeply distressed, and it always looks great bit of fun.
He forgot when he entered the ship, his umbrella, his watch, all his and rings and the clothing you bought for the trip. He had 42 boxes all carefully packed with his name painted clearly on each. Just since he omitted to mention the fact they were all left behind on the beach. His form is ungainly, his intellect small, the bellman would often remark. His courage is perfect, and that after all is the thing that one needs with a star. On when he came with three pairs of boots, but the worst of the woes, he had wholly forgotten his name. He would answer to high and to any loud cries, such as crime and refer to movie. To us you may call him, or what was his name, but especially thing number G. His form is ungainly, his intellect small, the bellman would often remark. His courage is perfect, and that after all is a thing that one needs with a star. While for those who preferred him a forcible word, he had different names from these. And his intimate friends called him Candle Ends, and his enemies Toasted Cheese. He came as a baker, but always a late, and it drove the poor bellman half mad. He could only bake rye cake, for which I may state no materials were to be had.
Quivering hands, chalk on the tip of his nose. Butcher nervous and dressed himself fine with yellow kid gloves and a ruff. Said he felt exactly like going to dine, which the bellman declared was all stuff.
that he stood in a shadowy court, with a snark with a glass in its eye, dressed in gown, bands, and wig, was defending a friend.
What's the good of Murgatroyd, North Poles, and equators, tropic zones, and meridian lines? So the bellman would cry, and who would reply? They're merely conventional signs. Other maps and set shapes, curious capes, we got our brave captain to thank. The crew would protest, he's brought us the best, a perfect and absolute blank. A perfect an absolute blank. A perfect and absolute blank. A perfect and absolute blank. Perfect and absolute blank.
And a scream shrill and high with the shuddering sky, and they knew that some danger was near. The beaver turned pale to the tip of his tail, and even the butcher felt strange, see. The thing can be done, said the butcher, I think. The thing must be done, I am sure. The thing shall be done, bring me paper and ink, the best there is time to procure. The beaver bought paper, bought for your pens and ink, an old and unfailing supplies. While strange, creepy creatures came out of the inks and watched them with wondering eyes.
You are in.
Stay. I'd 7 and 10 and multiply out by 1,000 diminished by 8. The result we proceed to divide, as you see, by 992. Then subtract 17, the answer must be exactly and perfectly true. Exactly and perfectly true.
You boil it in sawdust, you salt it in glue, you condense it with locusts and tape. Still keeping one principle, I'm rejecting you to preserve a symmetrical shape. You all it in sourdough, it's all it up and do to preserve a symmetrical shape. Still keeping one principle of rejecting you. You can dance with locusts and tape.
The method employed, gladly explain, while I have it so clear in my head. If I have but the time and you had but the brain, but much yet remains to be seen. It will move on a scene, what original's been enveloped in absolute mystery. And without extra charge, I'll a lesson in natural history.
You boil it in sawdust, you salt it in glue, you condense it with puffs and tape. Still keep on one principle of rejecting you to preserve a symmetrical shape. You all it in sawdust, it's all put up and do to preserve a symmetrical shape. Still keep on one principle of rejecting you. You can dance with your locus and tape.
As friends as the two in the story became, I seldom if ever been known. And winter or summer was always the same. You could never meet either alone. Seldom have ever been known. And winter or summer was always the same. You can never meet either alone.
With folks and a hole. He met threats and his life with a railway shade. He met Charlie with smiles and a soul. He may seek it with symbols and seek it with cake. He met Charlie with smiles and a soul. He met threats and his life with a railway shade.
Discounts. He offered a check drawn to bearer for £7.10,
but the bandersnatch merely extended its neck and grabbed at the banker again. When I rest or pause, while those fumious jaws went savagely stopping around, he skipped and he hopped and he floundered and flopped till fainting he fell to the ground. They shuddered to think that the chase might fail, and the beaver excited at last, when bounding along on the tip of his tail, for the daylight was dearly past. There was Shingleboom shouting, Bill and Sid, shouting like lead on the heart. He is waving his hands, he is wagging his head, he has certainly found the storm.
The energy until darkness came, found not a fiddle mark, by which they could tell they stood their way, a baker had met with a star. In the midst of the word he was trying to say, he had softly vanished away.
They gazed in the light while the butcher explained he was always a desperate way. They beheld him one name on the top of a neighboring crane,
a victim sublime for a moment of time, and the next hour figure they saw as a song by spasm plunged into a chasm while I waited and listened and all.
Suddenly vanishing away, the snark was a bosom, you see. almost saw it with cane, suited with books and hope. Threatened this life with a railway shade, charmed with smiles and soul.
Smiles and soul.